So one of the most difficult parts about being an eye doctor is watching people go blind. And probably the number one eye condition that I personally fear getting the most is one called age-related macular degeneration. And in this condition, people lose their central visual acuity. So they keep a lot of their side vision, but their center vision is gone. So imagine looking at your friends or your family and you can't recognize their faces either because it's too blurry or it's just gone. It's just a black spot. Same thing if you're trying to watch a movie or play a video game or read a book, then you can't see or do that. And sadly, no, at this time, glasses, contacts, even surgery, nothing can repair or restore this type of vision loss. And that is exactly why early diagnosis of macular degeneration is so important, so that we can make a diagnosis and begin treatment and lifestyle modification to hopefully delay or even prevent future vision loss. Now, a major thing about macular degeneration, as with many eye diseases, is that most people don't realize that there's a problem with their vision until it's already too late. In fact, about 80% of people with macular degeneration don't even seek care until they've already had permanent damage to their vision. But you see, vision loss and blindness is not the first symptom of macular degeneration. In fact, it's your loss of the ability to see in dim light or having night blindness. So let me know in the comments if you've ever had trouble seeing at nighttime or you feel like you're having more difficulties now these days, because I swear I hear a lot of people telling me here in the clinic that they're having a hard time seeing at night. But now we have this. This is the AdaptDx Pro from Maculogix. The AdaptDx Pro is a portable vision test that kind of looks like a virtual reality headset, but it tests what is called dark adaptometry, which is the ability to kind of measure how quickly our eyes adjust from a dark room to seeing subtle bright lights. So imagine going from a really bright room to going into a dark room, and you know how it takes some time for your eyes to adjust? It's kind of testing that time difference. There is a lot of science to it, but what's exciting is that they have found that with these tests, they can detect macular degeneration up to 3 years before we ever see anything in the back of the eye during an eye exam. And I'm always personally really excited about new technology in eye care, so a huge shout out to Maculogix for sponsoring this video showcase. It gives us a chance to look at the AdaptDx Pro and figuring out how it works, and then ultimately seeing how eye care professionals can use this technology to help people diagnose and treat macular degeneration earlier. This is the newest model of the AdaptDx, which comes with these rubberized eye cups, which block out and create kind of a light seal, meaning you can do this test basically anywhere you want because it's mobile. It also comes with this cool LCD screen here on the front, which is used to show kind of instructions and help any sort of technicians who may be running the test monitor the progress of the test itself. The way the test works is you're shown a dark black screen with a single red fixation target that you kind of focus on, and then they shine a bright green square that essentially kind of bleaches out your retinal photoreceptors. And then they start showing you very subtle incremental changes in light intensity, just kind of a little flash right where that green square was. And then you click a button whenever you think that you saw that green flash. And with that, they're able to map out how well your retina is able to adapt to these subtle changes in light intensities. Now, this class of technology of dark adaptometry and how it works is not really new. It's been around for a long time, and I can even remember learning about it in my vision science classes in optometry school. But this is the first time that it's ever really been made very user-friendly, portable, and ultimately just kind of this successful with technology, making it so that clinics can actually use it. Because before, in the olden days, it's something that just took way too long to run, and it was cumbersome, and just it wasn't really something that you could use outside of an academic setting. Now, the AdaptDx Pro has two different testing functions. One, which is just a screener test, which only takes about 5 to 7 minutes, which is awesome because it can be run at any regularly scheduled eye exam. And if the patient passes that screener test, awesome. But if they fail, then we know they're at risk and we can have them back for a more extensive test, which gives us more information and hopefully will help us diagnose if there is a problem with macular degeneration. Now, I even had a chance to test it out myself and it was kind of fun to do. And yes, I did pass, but while wearing it, you put it on and everything's super dark. It's kind of like looking with a blindfold on. You can't see very much at all. And then you have this voice that turns on and starts talking to you.
Please loosen the headset and reposition it so that the red light is directly across from your eye.
That's Thea. Thea is a multilingual AI that kind of coaches you and adapts to your performance during the test. And it's nice because at times when my eyes, I wasn't blinking very much, I was really focused, and my eyes were drying out, it would remind me to, hey, let's take a break, blink your eyes a few times, and then let's begin the test again. And they also included some eye tracking technology, so that if you do turn your eye away from the fixation target, then it's able to kind of notice that you're doing that and adjust accordingly. And I think this was really smart to include in this technology, because if you've done any other tests in the eye clinic, you can lose your confidence pretty quickly. Whether you're missing letters or you're taking a visual field test and you miss a light, you lose that confidence. And having this voice to kind of coach you through and encourage you to keep going or to take a break, it's just useful. It gives us better information, improves our confidence in the test results. And overall, I think it makes a better experience for the person taking the test too. But again, with this test, you see that red fixation light. When you see any other flashing lights, you click a button and it gets recorded. And after a few minutes, you're all set and done. But again, remember that this test measures your speed of dark adaption. And in eye care and all of healthcare, it's really important that we have studies to back up of how this works. And a really good study done between Harvard, Penn State, and Johns Hopkins found that the AdaptDx did have a 90% specificity and sensitivity for detecting the presence of AMD as an objective measurement of retinal function. Meaning with it, we can diagnose macular degeneration earlier and then begin treatment and lifestyle modifications so that hopefully we can again slow and even maybe delay vision loss. And those recommendations can be quitting smoking, prescribing nutritional supplementation to help slow the disease. It can include taking diet and exercise programs, and as well as managing other systemic diseases with a primary care physician. Even prescribing blue light and UV light blocking sunglasses or other technology to help prevent any sort of excess oxidative strain from exposure to sunlight and other harsh lights. Now, AdaptDx has been around since about 2014 and is becoming more widely available, but I think if you're somebody who has any risk factors, you're over the age of 50, you either are or have been a smoker in the past, or you have any family history of blindness or macular degeneration, then I would reach out to your local eye care provider and find someone near you that has something like dark adaptometry. You, of course, can easily just call local clinics and see if somebody has something like the AdaptDx, or you can check out the link I'll include in the description below, which will be a search engine so you can find other clinics automatically that already have the device. Again, huge thanks to Maculogix for supporting this video and getting us a chance to get our hands on the AdaptDx Pro so we can try it out ourselves. Let us know in the comments what you think of this cool technology, and overall, is macular degeneration a concern for you? Now again, there's a whole lot more for us to talk about when it comes to macular degeneration. If you want to learn a little bit more and you haven't seen our other videos, unlike the difference between wet and dry macular degeneration, check out those videos by clicking or tapping the screen over here to the side. Or if again you want to see other cool videos from Dr. Eye Health, you can click or tap the screen down over here. Again, thank you so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.